is presentation by Mello. She's going to present on minimalist and maximalist personality types. Over to you, Mello.
Thank you, Dr. Dumana. So this presentation was made by me and Vidisha, but she couldn't be here today, so I will be presenting it. To begin with, I just have a question for you all, a little food for thought. Have you ever had a day when you could not decide whether you wanted everything or just the bare necessities? Or moments in your life when you felt like keeping everything that you have or not having anything at all? When it comes to minimalism and maximalism, they are two very different lifestyles. And minimalism is a philosophy that has been going on for a lot of years. It's a philosophy of living with less, of being more intentional about what you buy, and believing that less, having lesser things is more and it's better for you. Whereas maximalism is the opposite. It started in the recent years, and it's a style or technique that embraces excess of and believing that more is more. And both of these have an effect on personality, feelings, and space decorations. Now, this is a stereotypical image of what a person might think when they think of maximalism and minimalism. With maximalism, you can see the colorful patterns, the large amount of objects placed there on the left side, whereas minimalism is usually seen as this very dry, clean aesthetic where there aren't many patterns and the colors tend to be very bland and kind of in the shades of whites and browns, etc. But this is a very surface level idea of these concepts, and they actually go a lot deeper into the way a person lives rather than just the superficial decorations themselves. So moving on to the traits that minimalists have. First is that they value experiences over possessions. So a minimalist would not be too worried about the things they have, and they would value experiences which help them connect to society and nature rather than anything that is about owning more objects or possessions. They also tend to be more patient and disciplined. And they're also comfortable with saying no to things because they are more intentional and aware about what they want in their life. And then the traits of maximalists is that they celebrate imprecision and diversity, and there might be a slight blurring of lines between reality and fantasy, and they encourage that spontaneous expression of yourself, and they champion that freedom of expression. Now, because maximalism is a more recent concept, we don't have that much information about how it would be affecting personality. So one of the main things that these two concepts affect is how a person feels about things. A maximalist is someone who would get attached to their things, whereas a minimalist is someone who would just see things as just that, things that serve some kind of a functional purpose. So maximalists would attach deeper meaning and purpose to their objects, and they would sentimentalize these belongings to the point that it becomes difficult for them to get rid of possessions even when they're no longer helpful in their life. The minimalist, on the other hand, believes that the object's value lies in its utility. So they're more likely to get rid of things when they're no longer needed, and they try not to attach sentimental value to their items. The exception to that would be if an object has sentimental value in the sense that it is connected to the memories of a loved one, or imagine something like a wedding ring, that obviously humans have these objects that do tend to have sentimental value. But a minimalist would only attach sentimental value to those special items and not get emotionally attached to their possessions in general. And minimalists trust that this lesser emotional connections to the possessions they have gives them more freedom to live their life. Now we're moving on to an interesting study on impression formation. Now, this was a series of experiments that showed that an individual's preference for minimalist or maximalist aesthetic depended on their perspective as to whether they were the observer in the situation or the actor. Now, what that basically meant was they were given a scenario, like a party or a meeting or something, and they were shown an object that was either minimalist or maximalist. In one scenario, they were observers. So they were asked, okay, if somebody was wearing this shirt, would you approach them? Would you feel like becoming their friend? And the options would be either a minimalist shirt or a maximalist shirt. So as observers, they judged other people's aesthetic choices for attractiveness, and they showed an increased preference for maximalist designs because all of that patterns and colors signaled warmth to them. So they perceived that other person as friendly and sociable. But when they were asked if what they would choose to wear to such a function in order to appear attractive to other people, they would choose the minimalist designs and show preference for that because in their mind that signaled competence. The minimalist aesthetic looked more professional to them and they felt like that would make them appear more attractive to other people. And lastly, we'll come to minimalism and well-being. There have been a lot of studies connecting minimalism to things like well-being and sustainable lifestyles. So this is because minimalism encourages a connection with other people and nature. And it also fosters a more intentional and aware mindset when choosing to consume. So rather than being swept away by the marketing strategies and everything, minimalists tend to be more intentional and aware of their purchases, which gives them that sense of control and satisfaction in life. And it also, because they don't attach that much importance to their possessions and they value experiences more, it allows these individuals to appreciate the everyday things that usually tend to go unnoticed. So all of these little things have connected minimalism to well-being in people. And as for maximalism, it's still a new topic. So we do know that there needs to be more research done on these two topics. And since maximalism is fairly new, we don't really know the larger impacts that it could have on a person's mental well-being and their personality. Whereas minimalism is something that has been well researched and shown to be a lifestyle or philosophy that has positive impacts on their life. So now I have a few questions for you. First of all, which of these traits is a minimalist more likely to have? A, impulsiveness. B, preferring instant gratification. C, making intentional and thoughtful choices. Or D, having difficulty getting rid of things. Right. I can see in the chat box everyone said C. You're absolutely correct. They make intentional and thoughtful choices. Next is, how is a maximalist relationship with their possessions? So A, they prefer experiences to objects. B, they feel sentimental about their belongings. C, they value utility over sentiment. Or D, they don't get emotionally attached to their belongings. Hey. Thank you for your participation. It is B, they feel sentimental about their belongings. Thank you.